All right. I will keep this hand. It's a little land heavy, but who knows? Again, my opponent could be playing smallpoxes and whatnot. We'll be finding out soon enough. Unfortunately, Inquisition is good against this hand because taking the Delver makes this a somewhat non-aggressive hand. Though, this is the sort of hand where if I draw Treasure Cruise, bam. Just like every other hand, in fact. Treasure Cruise is great. All right. Delver, of course, is the best card to draw here. The Eidolon's interesting. See what my opponent's got. Dakmor Savage, Dark Blast, Raven's Crime, Shrieking Affliction. That's the. That one? Oh, yeah, that's good here. In Thoughtseize. All right. Yeah, I'm gonna probe again. It's costing me a bunch of life, and with Shrieking Affliction, that actually might be relevant, but I think finding a Delver is just so valuable. Could also find a Serum Visions, and that could be decent as well. All right, there's the Serum Visions, which I actually think I'm getting a Steam Vents to go get. Brutal. But I want to be able to set up a turn two Eidolon. Basically, I guess my opponent's probably Thoughtseize the Eidolon, but I still think I get Steam Vents here. I'm doing a pretty good job of dealing 7 damage to myself on turn one. Oh yeah. All right. But look at it this way. I could cast Treasure Cruise on turn two. I don't want Remand or Bloodstained Mire, so that's it. And I don't need to cast Gitaxian Probe now. Man, Eidolon Great Role is really bad in this deck. I actually think it's a fine card to bring in when your opponent's not attacking your life total, but oh man, is it painful. Oh, my opponent cannot cast two things this turn because of the Dakmor Salvage. So I assume I'm getting Thoughtseized, but I might actually get to mana leak something, relevantly. Let's see if my opponent takes the Eidolon here. If they don't take Eidolon, if they just take mana leak, could set up a race situation. But I think that's okay for me. All right. I think I actually just. Oh, jeez, that's a Treasure Cruise. All right, I'm just gonna play a mountain. Actually, I'm gonna play Scalding Tarn and pass. Basically, I don't want to probe because I want to cast Mana Leak. I don't care about discarding like Lightning Bolt, and then next turn I can cast Treasure Cruise with Mana Leak up if my opponent does not present good targets for Mana Leak here. Am I mana leaking Wrench Mind? Yeah, probably. Am I mana leaking Shrieking, whatever. I'm not mana leaking Raven's Crime. Just discard Lightning Bolt. I'm not a spot where I really need Lightning Bolt anyway. And if I get Raven's Crime again, I think I just discard the Gitaxian Probe. Where it looks like I'm potentially getting Wrench Minded. No, it looks like my opponent's passing. All right. Well, I get to cast Treasure Cruise. My opponent gets to be jealous. Let's play a land. Let's cast Treasure Cruise. Getting rid of Delver. Getting rid of first all the non-Snapcaster targets. And then getting rid of. I'm gonna leave Gitaxian Probe or Lightning Bolt rather, sorry. Because I have Gitaxian Probe and Serum Visions in hand. Oh, do I wanna play Young Pyromancer? Well, I'll just wait. I'll mana leak. It time locks my opponent too. And if my opponent thinks the way to win is to Raven's Crime me as I'm casting Treasure Cruises, then go for it. Alright, Shrieking Affliction's a card. There's one or fewer cards in hand. Yeah, that's not gonna happen for a little while here. Alright, Alright, I guess I'm off the Mana Leak plan here. And I'm back on the Gitaxian Probe plan. I got a 10, I get some tokens. Dark Blast and Wrench Mind. And my opponent gets to Dark Blast away my Young Pyromancers and Wrench Mind me. And then I get to cast Treasure Cruise. Yeah, Dark Blast's actually pretty good here. My opponent did dredge it. And probably Wrenching now. I'm discarding 2 Mana Leaks, I think. And I'm still not getting Shrieking Affliction, nor am I going to anytime soon. And I guess I lead with Serum Visions here. Yeah, this is just like a case study on why Treasure Cruise is great. Let's put Pyromancer on top. Treasure Cruise, 1, 2. You know, it actually doesn't matter that much. I'm gonna get rid of all of them. Play land and hit my opponent for two. No, I don't really want to get hit by Mutavolt here. See what my opponent does. I assume not dredging, yeah. You don't really want to dredge there. Could be getting Raven's Crimed. In which case, I'm probably discarding Mana Leak again. Opponent's passing. Drawing Bolt would be pretty nice. The Delver's actually not bad. Can't quite cast Treasure Cruise. I'm going to keep my land in hand. Potentially discard to a future Raven's Crime, also because I don't want to take 3 damage off Shrieking Affliction. I assume my opponent's going to dredge the Dark Blast here. It's kind of insane not to. The Rack, jeez. Now, do you Dark Blast Pyromancer or Delver? Actually, it might be valid just to Dark Blast the Delver. If you Dark Blast Delver, then I don't have a chance to flip it. Are we passing the turn? Okay. In response, killing the Delver? Yeah. Alright, well, in that case, I will probably not reveal. The Bloodstained Mire is a card. Alright, so now I'm going to use this so I can cast a slightly cheaper Treasure Cruise because I want to play spells afterwards, especially with the Young Pyromancer out. Don't want to leave anything to delve. Nah. I'll have a Treasure Cruise already. Or Snapcaster or anything like that. Alright, now I get to attack with everything and Bolt Mutavolt. And it will be good. My opponent's casting Raven's Crimes, and I am casting Treasure Cruises, and that is awesome. Mutavolt successfully bolted, hit my opponent down to 14, and I might as well cast Serum Vision since I can still leave Spell Pierce up here. What are we drawing? Put Monastery Swift Spear on the bottom too. I don't think Swift Spear is very good, though. I guess I'm protected from Ensnaring Bridge. And did my opponent looks like my opponent did not dredge Dark Blast, and that'll do it.